mean, ready, steady, aim at the target. I'm flooding the market, a break from the garbage. An artist, sensitive about mind, pardon. No margin for error, flawless be rarer. The black cat goddess, you walking with a panther. Painting these pictures with words like...
Hey, it's your girl, Madam Money, aka Trap, 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 Trap. And welcome to the official Salt in the Game album review of ELZHI's 7 Down, 8 Up. Make sure you hit that like button, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and let's get it. Now, yo, I ain't even gonna hold you. I know a lot of people have been waiting to hear an album from him. This was exactly produced by JR SWIFTZ. He has a couple dope tracks floating around too throughout the year. So he, like, once I heard that he was going to be exactly producing this whole album and we got the first track off of there, Light One, Right One, I knew that this was going to be, you know, something that everybody was going to enjoy. And when I tell you I enjoy it, I did enjoy it. From the intro, the Foolish intro, you know, it comes through very, very, very tight, like just talking and letting you get into a feel of what is going on here, which I thought was dope. The next track on here is called Smoke and Mirrors, and that is a great opening track. Like, the production on this album is so streamless. This is one of those, like, streamless albums where the transition, everything is right and everything is hitting at the right time. Like, this is really, really a, like, a well put together body of work coming from them over there. The Smoke and Mirrors, like, joint is really like a self-reflection track, and, you know, make your reflection proud and all this stuff going on. And, you know, you might have been taught to do things the normal way, like get a job and go to school and all of this, but, you know, you got to do what's best for you in certain situations. I really do appreciate stuff like that coming out. The next track on here is called Early Bird Night Owl, and that's me right here. I just want to say that this track right here is dedicated to all my enemies, you feel me, because you don't understand what this particular grind is like when it comes across like this, you feel me. He had like a little Prozzo diss on here. Y'all be thinking y'all Nas when y'all really Proz with the Fugees. Was bumping in the Mitsubishi while eating sushi, hey, trying to diss the crew, and we don't play, no vacay or recess, not even where they surf or where they ski at. Like, yo, people don't understand what it really takes to actually be a grinder, no days off, no sleep, no rest, you feel me? Like, everybody always has this thing about them where it's like, you know, I do this and I do that and I do the most and I do the most here, but are you doing the most productive thing? Like, are you really in the grind session? And this is why I say, like, this is dedicated to them, to my enemies, because not only he's saying that he's this grindaholic, he always has this moral code about him and how he moves and stuff like that. And I really do appreciate this track a lot. I'm trying to make this paper, not make the papers or the free press. You understand? Like, you understand what that means? Like, only real niggas can relate to that shit. But, dope track. As we go on, Hot Winter, Cold Summer, and kind of reminds me of me. You feel me? I got a quote that I say all the time. I say, the streets is icy in July. You feel me? Like, and, you know, real niggas, they're gonna understand this, and, like, total wholeheartedly. It's crazy because this is, like, one of those things, and we're about to get into the second half of this, because after Light One, Right One, it's a track called Ferndale, and it takes like this storytelling tone where all of these ones up until Ferndale, he's talking to you, and then, like, on Ferndale, he's giving you a story, and then it, like, cuts at the end of it, and it goes into the second half of this album. And the second half of this album is like, now he's not talking to you, he's painting a picture for you of what is going on right now in this great storytelling track after track that he's portraying it to be a movie. Like, stuff like that is so interesting when it comes across here. And that's how you can tell too when people are actually listening to full bodies of work and not just skimming through it, because something like that you would miss, because it comes so far at the very end of Ferndale. You're like, hey, what's going on? It starts like flicking through the channel, it starts taking to another place. So on these first tracks, he's being very, you know, personal with you, he's talking to you, he's telling you what's going on, all at this high level of lyricism, like GOAT God status of lyricism. And then it breaks off and lets you see his, like, more conceptual side. And I really appreciate that coming from, like one body of work, when somebody is able to do that. That just lets you know the level that they're on is not nothing to be played with. So, after it breaks off into, Ferndale goes into this thing of guns and bolts, and that's just storytelling, another storytelling track, Thugged Out Zombies. He's like making this reference that everybody is like that. If you're still trying to walk in this path for, you know, like, you know, being the flashiest, being this and being that and being all burnt out and, you know, like, you know, partaking in things too much and stuff like that, you become this thugged out zombie. Even if it's all for, you know, trying to be the hardest and stuff like that, you become like a zombie to this shit. And like, dog, it really like blew me away the second half of this album. The next track on here is called Potential. The church is not the only place where they be clapping hands and stomping feet. Like, this is just letting you know, like, he's maintaining this level of realism going on in the second half of this album. But he's like, he's painting picture for you, like picture after picture after picture on these tracks. Well, like I said earlier in the album, he's talking to you, he's telling you, he's putting you up on game. He's talking about himself and how, like, you should be. And I'm not even offended by anybody even trying to do that. When it comes across something like this, it's crazy to me. The next track on here is called G.O.D. And like, he's talking to you, he's mixing these storytelling elements in there. G.O.D. on here, he does a lot of like word flips, you know, gold, oil, diamonds, gram, ounces, drug deals, guns, offense, dollars, good old dick, good old deep throat, good old dice games, like, you feel me? So it's giving you these levels of what is going on and stuff like that. I was really, really surprised by the end of that. Like, just talking to you about that type of thing, just showing you like this thing of, you know, old school versus new school type of thing. And that's what's going on a lot on here. It's like this really, on the second half of this, it's really this play on old school versus new school, and that really translates at the end of G.O.D. The next track on here is Masterclass. It has no hook, and this is the beat that is like a little bit different than, you know, the rest of the album. But since the transition came before that, at the end of G.O.D., it's like, it's not one of these, like, why is this here type of situations. It's one of these just like, oh, this is just a different vibe real quick, which I did appreciate on here. The next track after that is called Jason. It is a great outro. It's like, you know, it's like this sinister type of situation where he's just like, you know, like, really telling you the grittiness of what happens in the street. And again, just straight storytelling. And then again, like, it's just like this play off of, he ends the album with this play off of old school versus new school, where the guy is telling you and talking to you about, you know, I'm not the one out here doing all these dances and stuff like that. I hurt my back doing that. I tried to do blue face dancing, that stuff hurts. So you gotta recognize the real, like, you gotta deal with the real. And I appreciate those things too, it's too, but at the same time, I'm somebody who'd be like, you know, like, the youth have to have fun, you feel me? You know, in a perfect world, we'd be able to have these two things where everybody can get down and party and be, you know, all conscious in the same respect. But, yo, this was such a dope project. Like, I can't spit these words enough, because his bars, like, how he breaks down his bars, they are like long bars, but you never feel like it's like drawn out bars, because it's so much syllable work going on in between these things. Even that little piece that I spit off of Early Bird Night Owl, if you go through that, it's like so many, like, these syllables, like, not a word is wasted, not an opportunity to say what's real not is missed. Like, this is just like a dope project, and he always have dope projects. Let's just keep it real. Also too, a lot of his projects is now available on streaming, a lot of his earlier work, so make sure you check it out. But this right here, like, yo, this is something that, like, put me in a good place where it was kind of like I needed to, like burn sage and shit like that. And not saying it came across like that, but it was like, I just need to clear everything out so that I can get some real unadulterated hip-hop that was clear and concise like, this shit is crazy to me because I'm telling you, it's like two different albums, one in the same, where you get somebody really spitting to you, and then you get a whole second half of a concept album that's a full album. Like, these could have been two EPs total separately, and we'd be revering both of them, like, separate. We would be out here really going bananas over these two bodies of work separately, but since it's put together like this, like, yo, this is just a dope body of work. So I hope you guys are listening to it. Let me know what's your favorite track off of this album, but I'm about to get out of here. I'm Madam Money. You can follow me on Twitter at Madam Money Says. That's MadamMoneySays, and on IG, and like, I'm telling you, dog, like, you feel me, 7 times down 8 times up, like, so that mean we winning, right? You feel me? If we got 7 times down and 8 times up, we still winning, right? Better believe it. Peace.